Are you ready to boost your confidence when selling so you're able to close more deals? Nikki Roush will show you how to build a foundation of skills and a mindset that creates sales success without feeling pushy or salesy and without fear of rejection. She is a sales strategist and coach with more than 25 years of sales experience and is master certified in neuro-linguistic programming. This is a radically different approach to selling. It's a no sleaze, no slime, and no stress approach to building your business. This is Sales Maven. Here's Nikki.
Welcome, and thank you for listening to the Sales Maven Show. I'm your host, Nikki Roush. I am your own personal sales maven. I'm here to offer you tips, techniques, and strategies to master the sales conversation. Today's episode is an on-air coaching call with one of our Sales Maven Society members. I'm very excited to welcome to the show, Mridu Parikh.
Nikki, you nailed it. Thank you. And I'm so excited to be here. I cannot tell you how much I adore you, love everything you do. And I'm thank you for having me.
Well, I'm so excited you said yes. And I love what we're going to talk about today for coaching for you specifically. But before we get into all of that stuff, please tell the audience a little bit about you and what you do. And I had the pleasure of going through one of your trainings recently that you put into the Sales Maven Society. So I feel like I have a little taste of your work, which was fantastic. So tell everybody a little bit about you and what you do.
Oh, great. Thank you. Yeah, I'm Mridu, known as the Stress Squasher. I help working women wake up with a plan so they can conquer all their demands and all their distractions. So what that means is essentially I help you be focused, create systems, delegate, put up boundaries. And I truly believe that every woman can get exactly what she wants personally and professionally when she's in control of her intentions and her attention. So, so that's what I do for them.
So tell me the different ways that clients hire you. How do clients work with you?
I work with clients on a one-to-one basis. I work with them in a group program. And I do a lot of speaking. So I speak a lot of at conferences and associations or train in organizations.
What are your, what's your signature talk? What's the number one talk that you tend to go and speak on and do?
It's called Overwhelmed, Overstretched, and Over It.
Oh, that's so good. I love that topic.
Thanks. Yeah, that's definitely my most requested. And I can do it in a keynote format or I could do it in a longer, sometimes a training for an hour and a half kind of, you know, so it depends on what the needs are of the client.
Yeah, that's fantastic. I love the Over It. That makes me laugh. Oh, so good. So good. All right, friend. Well, tell me, how can I be of service to you today? What's something that we can work on that will be valuable for you as you are growing your business?
Yeah, well, something I'm struggling with right now is trying to figure out how to take my group program, which I offer usually by two or three times a year, and make it more of an evergreen offer, which for anyone who doesn't know what that means, but basically all year, you know, always open, in a way that people are still incentivized to join without that, you know, that start, here's when it starts, here's when it ends. And it's definitely a higher end, I guess, in terms of cost, it's a bigger investment. So it's not a membership that might be a $49 or $97. It's a pretty big investment. And so I don't know why. So because of that, I always feel like it's harder to just get somebody to roll into it versus if it was a smaller investment. And if I move to that, which is what I would love to do, because I really don't enjoy launching. I just hate the whole process of launching and all the emails and going through it and the webinar, you know, the whole thing, kind of getting people to it. Yeah. I'd love to just sort of keep it open, but I'm like, what is going to get someone to take action right now, let's say, and not put it off. They just know it's open forever.
Yeah. Yeah. Are you comfortable sharing on air what the price is for the program?
Yeah. Yeah. It's a $2,500 to $3,000, depends. And there's payment plans.
Okay. So if there was a payment plan and then how long is the program?
It's 10 to 12 weeks, depending on which version I'm doing.
Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. So if it's always open and people are just rolling into it, so you're not restarting it every 10 weeks or are you starting? So I need some help here, clarity.
Yeah, no, I'm not doing it every 10 weeks. I may be doing it like three times a year. So maybe like you know, and I usually start in February, March, and then maybe once the summer, and then at the end of the year in the fall.
So when you're talking about it being evergreen, how does that work then?
So there's some logistics stuff I've got to figure out too. Okay. And I think I would love your advice on that. I feel like I could figure that part out more. I could change it if I could figure out how to, you know, the sales side of it as well. But I'm thinking it would be structured a little bit differently than right now. So right now, obviously you start and it's 10 weeks and every week we're going through a particular part of the curriculum. Like I just give you a video series every week. I think if it was evergreen, you'd probably get the whole program at one time. This is how I'm picturing it. And like all the modules and all the training. And then on the calls, it might be more of like a open Q&A, like just ask me questions and we discuss versus a really particular focus topic for that week. In which case I think I'm willing also to bring down the price point because it is a little different. I do feel like the way I have it right now, it is quite personal coaching and the groups are small, right? So we're like 6 women, 8 women. And so I can do a lot of really personal coaching. I'm hoping if it's opened up, maybe it'll be bigger and then maybe, but it wouldn't be, it's still personal, but we're not all going at the same rate and the same level.
Okay.
Does that make sense? Same speed.
I think so. Yeah. I think so. So sometimes there is some advantage of people being at different stages and asking different questions, right? Because then it'll prompt somebody who's earlier on to have something to look forward to of like, oh, I can't wait until that's my question.
Right.
And then you have somebody who is been in the program for a while, who has implemented and they hear a question from somebody who's relatively new. Then what that does is it reinforces them how much progress they've made because they're like, oh, I remember when I was there and that was my question. And or oftentimes what happens is that like people will go through something, they'll learn it, but then a couple of weeks go by and they kind of forget, right? And so then when they get that question come back up, it's easy for them to go like, oh yeah, I need to go back and implement more of this into my own life. And oh yeah, I remember how powerful that was earlier on and I kind of got away from it and now I need to go back to it. So there is some advantage to having people at different levels in that way. And you can still do these like deep dive like coaching for people, right? Because you're learning a little bit about them and you give very specific answers. I mean, I feel like I do this in the membership too, right? Like it doesn't really matter who's asking the question. Like the question is answered and tailored to that person, but then other people in the room are like, oh, dang, I needed to hear that today, right? So that's where you're going to get that piece of it. I'm wondering if you want to, at the end of the program, have an offer for people who just went through the program to stay and have access to Q&A for longer periods of time with you. I don't know if that's a possibility. And then that becomes like another 10-week commitment or a 12-week commitment, or maybe it's just a month to month. They go month to month and then it kind of is like a subscription type membership type model, right? And then as far as selling it so that it's this evergreen product, I mean, you don't have to do like the big, big launches, but you are going to still have to do things for enrollment. Like as much as we want to get to this place where like, hey, you know, people now just come to my website and pay me money and sign up for my programs. Like, I think we all aspire to get there. And I think very few of us find that to be the case. You're always still building and working. So figuring out what are the things that do enroll people into the program and doing that more regularly. So instead of doing a big, big launch to your list, maybe what you're doing is every month you're doing a version of the webinar that drives people into the program. And that's a free thing. And you're promoting it every week every month you're promoting it. So you're doing it once a month. That's driving new traffic or new people into the program and having them sign up. It's still up on your website, right? That they can sign up at any point, but doing some type of a training or something, like what is the thing that tends to convert people? Like what are you doing now in your launches that's the conversion?
I think why I'm so torn about this is because it's the deadline. I feel like I'm always freaking out before my thing, it's not filled. And then the day of that deadline, I feel, you know, it gets filled.
Okay.
And so that's, I think that's what I'm like really struggling with. Like if there's not that deadline, you know, then they're like, oh, well, we have to wait. Cause I'm honest. I'm like, I think I'm going to run it again in the summer. I might not, you know? And so, and then like, okay, we'll sign up. And so I think that's really the main thing that I'm like, this keeps happening with the deadline.
Okay. So the way that you can do that is you could still build in a deadline for people to sign up, right? So if you're putting on some type of a little like training every month, and frankly, it's the same training every single month. Like I do this in my webinars where I teach the same content every month that drives people into the Sales Maven Society. And the sense of urgency that's created is that there is a special offer for people to join from that training, and it has a 3-day expiration to it. Okay. So you could put some type of an incentive that when you sign up within 3 days of attending the training, then this, and you have to have an email sequence to support it too, by the way. Which is something like that I teach in the masterclass on conversion email sequences. I actually give my sequence for this because you, that sequence matters, because you're right. A lot of times people wait until that very last day to sign up. So I have, like, if I'm teaching it as a, like I do a free training, I send an email that is set up to go 15 minutes at the end of the training that says, thank you so much for being here. The recording is going to be available later today. You'll get an email about that. In the meantime, here's the special offer. And then I send an email later that day that says, here's the recording in case you weren't able to make it live, or in case you want to watch it again, by the way, here's the special offer again. And then I say in there that you have 3 days from today's date to, I actually say you have 3 days from today to take me up on this offer. Now, I don't actually put the date in there because then I don't have to rewrite these emails and change them every single month. Okay.
Okay. Yep.
And then on day three, I send a reminder, hey, this is the last day to take advantage of this special offer. We'd love to have you join us. Here it is again. Here's the link. Now you have to do something that's going to drive traffic. Now, the other thing that I do with this is so a lot of the traffic that gets driven into that, the webinar for me or the training, I like to call it a training and not a webinar, but, it comes from actually paid advertising that I'm doing. A lot of those signups come from that. And then the morning of, I send an email to my whole list, minus the Sales Maven Society members, because they're already in there, right? They don't need to come to this. I send an email that says, hey, this training is happening. And if, you know, in an hour or two or whenever it is, we'd love to have you join. Here's the link. You can still register. And I also, I always get signups the morning of people sign up to come to the training. Now, I don't get a ton of people come to every single month. And, but the thing is that I get signups every time I teach it.
Okay.
So you could do something like that, but you've got to do, there has to be some kind of a reoccurring promotional piece to it, because you have to be promoting it all the time. So for me, it's doing a training, because the training converts. Sometimes I get kind of bored with doing the training, frankly, because then I want to test other things. So then I do do some type of a test, right? Like I'll do some special offer for people to come join the Sales Maven Society. Like, here's a special offer for you to like dip your toe in the water. Or with you, because it's like set curriculum, you might not want to always be offering a discount on it. It might be a bonus that they would get, like, hey, when you sign up for the, like sign up by this date, here's this bonus piece that you're going to get. And I have all kinds of ideas for bonuses for you, but.
Well, I'd love to jump into that too. I was going to ask, when you're sending, when you're doing the training every month, and I've been to that, and that's how I got into the society.
Awesome.
Did you, are you sending out that email to your whole list every month, your email list? You are. Okay.
So what I do is I put it, so I send a newsletter every single week. That's like the, you know, sales content for people. And in the newsletter, there's a little section that says upcoming events. So I'll have that, the free training, the free webinar, that will be there and people can sign up from that. And that goes out every single week. So it's not a, like a big set, like launch, right? It's just there. And then I'm doing ads that are driving new traffic, people who maybe have never heard of me before, and they need a little bit of experience in order to say like, yeah, I'd take a chance with this lady or not. So those are the primary people. And I do have an email sequence that goes to them when they sign up for the webinar. And then the morning of, I send an email to my whole list, again, minus society members, because I can, you know, take out certain segments of people from my list. I send it to the whole list saying like, hey, we're starting in a couple hours. There's still time to register in case you'd like to come. Because sometimes people will be on my list for a year before they're like, oh, I have time today. I'm going to go check out Nikki's, you know, webinar or her training. And then they come and they're like, oh, I'm in. Now, here's what can happen though. Sometimes this does happen, is sometimes I will have people will come to the exact same training multiple times. I have one person who it took her 7 times of coming to the training before she signed up for the Sales Maven Society. It's the same content every time.
Right.
Now it's different in that I do Q&A at the end. And so maybe she comes, I don't know. I've never asked her actually, like maybe she comes for the Q&A because depending on the answers that, or the questions that people ask, I'm going to give a different answer, you know, to the question. Mm-hmm. But she's, I don't know. She was like, I learned something every time. Like we have talked about it, but not like specifically like why 7 times, but she's like, oh, I just learned something every time. I'm like, okay, well, good.
Yeah. Right.
So, yeah. Okay. So having something, and you already have the training, right? Now you could
have the training.
You could set that up to be evergreen too, where they could just go and watch it on demand.
Right.
There are some people that do it. Most of my clients who try to set up an on-demand, like evergreen type conversion training tend to not convert as well. Cause there is something about you being live and interacting with people.
I totally agree. It just does not appeal to me. I totally agree. Even on like the receiving end, like I'm just never really interested nearly as much as like I said, how I saw you on your training and, you know, just seeing somebody live and being able to ask live questions. And then it drives me crazy is when people do those webinars that are, you know, pre-filmed or pre-recorded and then you can't forward on them. Oh my gosh. I want to like strangle somebody. You know, they like make it so you can't push forward. And I'm like, I just want, you know,
I can't speed it up, right? Like, cause I don't listen to anything on like, on whatever people's standard rate of speech. There's very few people that I don't speed up. Like I can't listen to my own self talk. Like if I'm going to listen to a podcast that I like, oh, I'm going to go listen to this podcast that I was on. I always have to speed it up because my own rate of speech drives me crazy. Like everybody like talk faster. I want to hear it faster. I want to consume it faster.
Time is valuable. Time is money. Yeah, no,
right.
Totally.
That's right. I only have 10 minutes right now. I got to get through it as fast as I can. Right.
I know. No, I'm with you. And I've always I've wondered, do you do this the same thing every month? But I guess you do. You're saying you do. I mean, I knew, and I've heard you say that before. You do the same content, but I guess I just got to like wrap my head about that and just say,
it can feel like people are going to get bored. But the thing is that we're doing it for the new people. We're not doing it for the people who are like, I just want to consume as much of your free content as I can over and over and over again. So please give me new free content every single month, which I used to do early on in my business. And I just found that once you find the training that converts, that's the training you want to give. Now, sometimes I'll change the title of it and I might tweak it just a little bit just to test it. And which I did do actually the last time I taught it, I changed the title of it. And I actually got more signups, but less people came live and I didn't get as many conversions as I normally get. So I'm going to go back to my old title and try it again and see like, does this convert better or you come up with some other way to, you know, you do some type of a promotion around people coming in because even though you're selling something that it becomes this evergreen there are still people, hopefully you're building your list every month. We did not talk about this. Are you building your list every month?
Some months are a lot stronger than others, but yeah, I mean, I'm definitely trying. I'm on podcasts all the time. I blog, I have my own podcast. I'm writing articles. So I'm doing all the things. And, you know, sometimes it's like a big jump and other times it's just not. So
yeah. Well, I get it. Yeah. So as long as you're building your list and you're bringing new people in, and the thing is like, I don't know, do you know that? I don't know. Is that, it's like when the student is ready, the teacher appears. Do you know that?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So there will be people who have been on your list who've probably never even noticed that you even did some type of a free training.
Yeah.
And even though you're like, what? You've been on my list. You've gotten 10 emails about it. Like I can track it back. And they're like, I've never seen this email before. Cause that's just like, when we're ready for something, we pay more attention to it. So when you have somebody who's feeling overwhelmed in their life and is ready to really figure out a strategy and a structure to be more productive and live this life that they want to live, oh, here you are right now at a place where they're like, I am so over it. What else is there? Oh, here you are. I'm going to sign up for this and come check you out and see if you have something valuable that I will benefit from, because I'm ready to make a change. So you just have to keep being in front of people.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that's just good to keep in mind. You feel like you're driving. I feel like I'm driving people crazy with the same thing, but I think you're right. You have to hear it so many times. So,
and people never see it or hear it as many times as you think they do.
Right.
Like I struggle with this constantly. Cause I always go like, I just say the same things over and over and over again. But there are clients who have been clients for a while that I will say something to them that I'm like, I assume they know this because I say it, you know, 1,000 times a week, it feels like. And they'll go like, I've never heard you say that before. I'll be like, what? How is that even possible? Right? Because if I had a dollar for every time I said it, I'd make so much money every week. So we just have to remember that even if you said it to them, they might not have remembered it. They didn't hear it. They weren't ready. Mm-hmm. And so it's when they're ready that people come. Like I just worked with a client yesterday who, like, she really, in my mind, she came up out of the blue. Like she went onto my website and she booked an all day VIP day with me, which rarely happens, frankly. Like I usually will have had a conversation with somebody and I didn't know where she came from. She booked this all day VIP day with me. So the first thing I asked her when we got on the call is like, how did we get connected? And she's like, somebody told me 5 years ago that I had to work with you. And I just wasn't ready. And then I talked to somebody else like last month and I was telling her what I was going to do and who I needed some help with. And she was like, you have got to talk to Nikki Roush. So I just went on your website and I just booked it. And I was like, but she heard about me 5 years ago. I have no way to know. Like she doesn't even know who told her about me 5 years ago.
Right. Right. No, so it's amazing how those things just come back. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, cool. No, I like the system because I'm all about systems. This is what I do. And so I'm not afraid of the system. It was more of just like how to, kind of get people in and incentivize it. And I think you're right. I think just doing the training every month could be really great. And do we have time to talk about bonuses, some ideas you said you have?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So there's a lot of things that you can do. There's always the idea of like, there's some special incentive price wise, right? That there's some discount to sign up, but there's also this way to give a bonus. So one of the things that you had mentioned is that people like this, like tailored coaching from you, right?
Yeah.
So one of the bonuses that you could give if you're interested in doing this is you could give a 15-minute spotlight coaching private one-on-one session with you. This is a bonus that I use all the time. And frankly, it works in so many ways. One, I do have the, like, it's a paid service. So they get to see, like, if you go look for this, you can schedule this with me and I charge a certain amount of money for it. So there's a value to it. Like already there's a value because people do pay for these 15 minutes, but then I will bonus people with a 15-minute private coaching session with me. And when I do that private 15-minute coaching session with them, and you could decide how much time it is, I probably wouldn't do more than 30 and maybe 15 is enough. Like think about how much time do you need with somebody to like really deliver? I know in 15 minutes, I can definitely deliver something of value. So if you could do that and you assign a value to it, that's a huge bonus, because then they get like this private time with you. It's just you and them, and it feels very personal. It gives you time to really build some rapport. They're going to be more excited about the program. They're going to feel better when they show up to the live coaching calls in a group setting, because they're already going to feel like, you know, we're, you and I, we're connected. Like we've already had our one-on-one time. So that would be a really great bonus to offer.
Yes.
The other piece is that you could offer this incentive of allowing them to have longer access to the Q&A after the week, the program is over, the 10 or the 12 week program is over.
Right.
They could get a longer period of time access, like, and you would assign a value to that as well. Now, the advantage to doing that is, one, is it keeps more people coming to ask questions, which builds more value for the other members that are in there. And you're going to do them anyway. So it's not a huge, like, it's not a huge time suck to you to give something like that as a bonus, but is a huge value to the person who's getting it.
Yeah. Yeah. In general, I was thinking not as a bonus, but to just, and also, so right now, the way the program's set up, it's every week we're meeting.
Yeah.
And I was thinking if it's this new way, it would be every other week, which means I could really double their time into it, into the program. I could possibly say 15 or 20 weeks, right? Because it's every other week we're meeting versus every week. Because I think that would help me as well. And also extend the time for people, but it's not really a bonus. I was just thinking in general, of how I might structure that.
Do you have thoughts on that? It's a little bit of a counter to that is people who may not have a lot of exposure to you and are just coming, they get this one time, this free training with you. It's a lot to ask people to jump in to something that's like 20 weeks or 25 weeks.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. Right.
And so that actually could, and I don't, you could test it, but that could actually be a deterrent for somebody. They're like, I liked her. She seemed nice, but what if she's crazy? Like, do I want to be stuck with her for 20 weeks? Mm-hmm. Right. So I am always a little hesitant of making a program longer, because most people have such a hard time committing to anything as it is, that by making a program stretch out longer, even though, yes, it would be a huge value, once they're in it, they're going to get the value out of it. But that's where I'm saying, like, you could offer this extra, like, keep going, you can stay in the Q&As, let them get really exposed to you in a, like, in a deeper connected way, versus trying to sell now a 20-week program.
Right.
I'm a little nervous for you about that.
Okay. All right. Well, it's definitely something for me to think on. I like that. Awesome.
All right. Well, I'm excited to hear how this goes as you test it and see. So let us know in the Sales Maven Society how things are going with it. And then, so as we wrap up, I always like to ask two questions. First is, you know, you've been a member now of the Sales Maven Society for a while. What is one of the benefits that you've received from being in the group?
Well, I absolutely love just the people, the caliber of people. Everyone there is just super supportive. But I will say one of my favorite things is you rewriting the sales questions, or people are always writing in like, can you help me write this? Can you help me say this better? Can you help me put this in the right language? And then you literally rewrite it. And that's got to be my favorite thing ever. Cause I just know anytime I have a doubt on how to do it, I can just pop in and I was like, okay, she's really going to help me out. So that's one of my favorite parts.
Oh, thank you. I love that part of it too. All right. And then now, how can people get a hold of you? Because there's probably some people that are over it and are ready to take some steps. So how can people reach you?
Well, all things Life is Organized. So lifeisorganized.com is my website. If you want some free resources on just how to stop feeling overwhelmed and stop procrastinating and start getting focused, you can also go to lifeisorganized.com/resources. But I'm also on Instagram and Facebook. And lastly, I'll just also say, I have a podcast called Productivity on Purpose, which I think is really great. If you want to get to know me better, my personality, and you're a working lady with all the things, all the demands on you, might be a good place to go.
Okay. I feel like I didn't know that you had a podcast, and now I'm like, okay, so at the end of your podcast, there needs to be a really strong call to action for your listeners to come join your program.
I think that'll be definitely a new thing. I mean, I have been doing that when I'm promoting it. So I just actually finished a launch and I have a group I'm going working with the group. So okay. I figure I'll put this all into action in about 3 months once I get through this yes. group. But when I was promoting it, I was certain I was definitely doing that, you know, a couple of weeks up to it. But I think this just needs to be just a probably a constant thing every time.
Yeah.
Yeah. To get them to that training, right? Yeah.
Yeah, because your listeners, the people who are listening to you, they're listening to you for a reason. They're getting value out of it. And I think, you know, like there's one thing listening to somebody's podcast and there's something else of coaching with somebody. Like if you think you're getting something awesome from somebody's podcast, you can bet that you go and work with that person and you're going to get something that's like so much more in-depth, personalized. You're going to get results faster. Like that's just the nature of, at least that's been my experience. Every time I hire a coach who I listen to their podcast, I go work with them and I'm like, dang, this is night and day as to, I thought what I was getting with the podcast was awesome, but what I get here. So we want to make sure that people are always getting that, that opportunity to come join the program. And it has to be consistent because you don't know if somebody's only listening to one episode.
Right.
Right. Like we can't assume that they've heard every episode. So one out of five times I mention it. No, you got to mention it every time because that might be the only episode that they listen to and then they're ready to take action.
So are you getting them over to the training, right? Or to the right to the program, you think?
I would send them right to the program.
You would? Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Because they're already listeners. They're already like fans in some way. Otherwise, they would have turned you off before they even got to the end of the...
That's true.
Okay. So keep it consistent in there. Like you're building your audience. That audience, they're going to be your loyal, like... I love actually when somebody is a listener and then comes and joins the Sales Maven Society. One is they already have some exposure to my work. So that know, like, and trust factor is already there. And they become really great contributors because in a way, you know, when you listen to somebody on a podcast, they already feel like they know me. Right. Yeah. And so they're much more comfortable asking me questions. They're much more comfortable engaging in the group because they already feel like, well, I already have a relationship with her in some way. So there's like a different comfort level. We don't get a lot of really shy people. Like they're not like, oh, I'm afraid to ask this question because I don't know if it's okay. They're like, oh no, I feel like I already know Nikki. So I'm definitely going to ask her the question.
Yeah, for sure. Have you ever met someone somewhere that has listened to you that you don't know? And then they ask you something that you're like, wait, how did they know that? Like someone recently asked me about a renovation in our house. I just met them. And I was like, how do you know that? And I was like, oh, wait, that's right. You listen to my podcast.
Yes,
for a second. You're like, wait, what?
Yeah. It's super flattering to me that somebody repeat back something like, you know, you said such and such on the podcast. I was like, I did? Interesting. So I get that too. It's fun. Yeah. All right. Well, so happy to have you here. Thank you so much. Now, as we wrap up for today, if you are listening to the podcast, you know that 2021 is my year of the question. And I know that you will have better success in your sales when you ask better questions. So here is one question for you today that you can work into your conversations today or in your conversations with prospective clients. What's your biggest struggle in regards to, and then you insert your context here, or you could say, what's been your biggest struggle in regards to productivity, or what's been your biggest struggle in closing the sale, whatever your context is. And then oftentimes it helps plant that seed for somebody of like, oh yeah, this really is a problem for me. And when they share whatever it is that they're sharing, their answer to that question, that is your opportunity to go like, here's the gold here. Here's how I know how to position back my offer to them based on making sure that I'm helping them overcome that struggle. And or maybe it's a way for you to identify this isn't an ideal client. That's okay too. But ask people, what's been your biggest struggle in regards to, and then insert whatever the context is. So that's your question for today. As we wrap up, if you are not yet a member of the Sales Maven Society, you're invited to join. This is absolutely the best place for you to start igniting your sales. This is where you and I connect. You bring your questions, you bring your concerns, and frankly, you bring your sales emails and you post them in the group. I will provide answers, feedback, suggestions on how to improve your sales situations. You will gain confidence in your selling abilities and you'll be connected to an incredible group of people. So come join us today. You can join the Sales Maven Society by going to salesmavensociety.com. This is a monthly membership. It's $147 a month. And as a listener, you can join when you use the trial code 47TRIAL. This will get you your first month for only $47. So you'll see there's a place there for you to enter a coupon code. It's 47TRIAL. Put that in. It takes $100 off your first month. Come hang out with us and see if this is the place for you and how I can support you to boost your confidence and grow your sales this year. Thank you so much for listening. I appreciate you and I hope to talk to you again soon. Thanks.
Thanks for listening to Sales Maven. Visit us online at yoursalesmaven.com/maven for more resources to boost your confidence and skills.